So in this video, we are going to start exercise 4.2, question number first and the third. So we are going to learn how to construct the quadrilateral lift and the rhombus bend. So exercise 4.2, question number first, let us construct the quadrilateral lift, L-I-F-T. So what is the first step? I told you in my previous video. The first step is we have to draw the rough sketch so that we can get the idea from where we have to start. So let us draw the rough sketch, L-I-F-T. So when you are giving the name, you can give the name from any point. You can start giving the name from any point, but make sure you are giving in the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. You can't jump directly from L to F. Okay, so now let us write the measurements. Li is 4 cm, If 3 cm, Tl is 2.5 cm. So these three sides are given and two diagonals are given. So the diagonal Lf is 4.5 cm and the another diagonal It, which is 4 cm. Right, so let us start. This quadrilateral also divided into two triangles, like actually four triangles. From the, let us take the diagonal LF as the base. You can start with the IT also with the base. So now let me see why I'm starting with LF, because if you're starting with LF, you have given FI and LI. But if you will start with TI also, you can start. You can get the LI4 and TL4, right? So with any of the diagonal, you can start here in this question. So LF we will draw, that is 4.5 cm. Now we have to locate the point I. Okay, because we cannot start with point T, because we do not know from F to T the distance, the measurement is not given. So this side, right hand side below of the LI, LF, the both the measurements are given. So we are locating the point I, which is at a distance 3 cm from F. So as usual, we have opened the compass 3 cm and we have just draw an arc. Now we are locating, we have to locate the point I. So I is at a distance for 4 cm from L. So let us open the compass 4 cm and from L as center, we will cut the previous arc. Let us cut the previous arc which we drew from F. Now here from L 4 cm we have got the intersection point of these two arc. That point is the point I, right? So this is point I. Now if we will join FI, that is 3 cm, and LI is 4 cm. So we have got our point I. Now we have to locate the point T. T is given 2.5 cm from L. Let me first write the measurement. Always write the measurement given. Okay, this is very important. So if you are not writing, the marks will be deducted. Okay, now so let us locate the point T, which is at a distance 2.5 from L. So we are keeping the compass at 0 and we will just set the compass 2.5. Very carefully you have to select. Okay. 2.5 means it should be 2.5, it cannot go 2.4 or 2.6, right? So 2.5 we will take. Yeah, so here it is 2.5. So LS center, we will just draw an arc which is at a distance of 2.5. So somewhere here on this arc we will get the point T. Now how we will intersect the point T? Because T point, we have to look at the exact position, right? We do not have FT, distance is not given. So how can we look at the point T? What is given? You can see another diagonal is given, IT. The distance of IT is 4 cm. So what we can do? We can keep our compass at I and set the distance 4 cm. Then I as center, you have to find the point. You have to intersect that previous arc. Now you can see the previous arc, I am not getting the intersection point, right? I had to little bit more bigger arc I had to draw actually. So now let me again see LT 2.5. So I'm just taking LT 2.5 and I'll just making it little bigger, larger, so that it can intersect the arc which I have drawn from I. So now here we have got it. So this is the intersection point. Okay, so now let us join the point L. This intersection point we have got, it is T. So let us join LT and LF. And when you are joining, always write the measurement given. What is LT? LT is given 2.5 centimeter. And what is TF? TF is not given, right? But another diagonal is given, that is IT. So we have to join IT also. You have to join here. If you are not joining here, the marks, some marks will be deducted here because you have not shown the another diagonal which is given. So another diagonal we have IT. So let us join that diagonal also, IT, which is 4 centimeter. Yes, and write all the measurements. So we have done with our quadrilateral LIFT lift. So now this is the way we are drawing the quadrilateral. And about the steps of construction, that I will give you in the last of the this in the last at the end of this video. For one question I will tell you how to write, then you can write in your own words the steps of construction. The way you are constructing, the same you have to write step 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so let us start the another quadrilateral. It is the third question of exercise 4.2, where we have to construct rhombus, rhombus bend, BEND. And here only two diagonals are given. See, how do I know these are the diagonals? So let us draw first rhombus BEND. If you will write the names, you can start B from any of the point, right? As I told you in the previous question also. So let us start from this. You can start from any of the point, right? Any of the vertex. So BEND. Now the measurements are given BN. And BN is here diagonal, right? When you will join B and N, it is a diagonal. So BN is 5.6 centimeter given. And DE, another diagonal, that is 6.5 centimeter. This is 5.6 BN and DE is 6.5 centimeter. Right, so these two diagonals are given in this question. But you know the property of rhombus. What is the property of rhombus? Rhombus, all the four sides are equal. But we don't have given here any of the side, right? So how we will draw this? This is a little tricky question, right? So here two diagonals are given, but we have to start with some of the diagonal. Now I will start with the diagonal DE 6.5 centimeter. Why I'm not starting with BN 5.6? I can start with BN 5.6 also, right? Because it will divide this rhombus in two parts, in two triangles. But I'm starting with 6.5. Now I will tell you later why I'm starting with 6.5. So let us draw DE first, that is 6.5 centimeter. Using only these two measurements, we have to draw this rhombus. So this is DE 6.5 centimeter. After drawing, always write the measurement. Now see, another diagonal BN is given. Okay, so that diagonal, if I will draw somewhere, it will be like in a cross shape, right? So what I will do first, you know the property of rhombus. The diagonals are intersecting, right? Perpendicular bisectors. So diagonals are perpendicular bisectors, so that means I need to draw the perpendicular bisector of DE first. What is the perpendicular bisector? Perpendicular bisector which will divide, intersect, which will divide this line DE into two equal parts. And that line will be perpendicular. So how to draw the perpendicular bisector? Keep the compass at D. Just open more than half and draw the two arc up and down. Same compass E and intersect the previous compass arc which we drew from point D. Now join these two points. Yeah, join these two points. So this line, this somewhere the point, this B and somewhere on this line, right? Because this is a perpendicular bisector. Here, this is a perpendicular line and this is a bisector also. So DE, this line is dividing DE into two equal parts, right? Now Bn is 5.6. So what we are going to do, we will divide Bn. This Bn is this line, intersecting line, this. Okay, so it is dividing into two equal parts because it is a diagonals are perpendicular bisector. So I will divide 5.6 into two equal parts. If I would have taken 5.6 as a baseline, it would be difficult to divide 6.5 into two equal parts, right? It is odd. 6.5 is odd. 5.6 is even, so it is easier to divide it. So 5.6 is 2.8. Now let us set the compass 2.8. I will keep the compass at this center point, this DE. Okay, the DE is a, this is a middle point of DE, right? Now here from this point, I just cut this perpendicular bisector up and this down. So this is the length which is BN. This point we have got BN. And if we measure this length, it will be 5.6, 2.8 on above and 2.8 down. Okay, so this is a very important property of rhombus where the diagonals are perpendicular bisector. If you do not know this property, it would become difficult for you to construct this rhombus. Now join the points D from B, EB, and then E, then EN and ND. And we have got our rhombus bend, BEND. Now for cross checking, you can cross check your all the sides. All the sides mean DE 6.5, you can cross check BN. The length of BN will be 5.6. So the this point, the perpendicular bisector which is dividing D into two equal points, from this to B it will be 2.8, and this point to N will be 2.8. That is the reason we did not take 6.5 initially. So we have got our rhombus bend. Now I am going to show you how to write the steps of constructions. So you can see the steps of constructions, and this construction is done. Now here the points of the steps of construction. Just now we constructed the rhombus bend. So these are the points, the steps of construction. Just go through all these steps. Just pause the video and you can read it out. So similar way, you have to write the steps of construction for the other questions also. So hope you enjoyed the video. So do like, subscribe and share my channel, Milestone Maths, your math buddy for miles. Thank you for watching.